The Premier has hit back at protesters he's accused of threatening his family. He also took a swipe at Liberal MPs who've mixed with the crowds at Parliament House. Stephanie Anderson reports.
Smaller in numbers, but still sticking it out.
Save our country!
Protesters occupying Spring Street, now restricted by new barriers, as the Premier fires back at those who've taken their anger too far.
There are some people who are threatening me, they're threatening my family. They are essentially attacking the safety of my family. Be really clear and hear this message. I will not be deterred from the work I'm doing to keep every family safe.
Several Liberal MPs have now ventured out to mix with protesting crowds, some taking to the podium, others posting selfies as proof.
Yesterday I did speak to some people who have very genuine concerns, as do we.
Politics is often about what you stand for, and I don't think that ordinary, hard-working, mainstream Victorians, those who are not ugly extremists, will easily or readily forget who's been out on the front steps currying favour with extremists.
Not every single person out there is committing, saying silly things. The majority are not. Or when unionists turned up at the front of Jeff Kennett's house, you wouldn't blame everyone in the Labor Party for that.
Inside, the pandemic bill debate took a break. It'll resume again tomorrow. Legal opinions divided as to whether it meets the mark.
The government's gone to a great length to get that balance right.
We aren't entirely satisfied, though, with the final product. We think there's still some work to be done to really make it fit for purpose.
The coalition is still calling for a slowdown.
Why is Victoria the only state in Australia that needs to rush through legislation like this?
Because the Premier says with the state of emergency expiring, it's needed to keep some COVID rules running even after we're 90% vaxxed, and he doesn't have time to get everyone on side.
None of us have the luxury to consult and consult and consult in order to achieve universal support. Even the greatest critic of this bill, I think, would accept that it's a better set of arrangements than the current Public Health and Wellbeing Act.
Stephanie Anderson, Nine News.
Dougal Beattie joins me live from State Parliament. Dougal, the speculation tonight a former Labor minister could derail the pandemic bill.
Yeah, after being banned from Parliament, suddenly Adam Somurek is firmly back in the picture. Today he confirmed his vaccination status with the Upper House, meaning that he can return for tomorrow's vote on the pandemic bill. Adam Somurek's return has prompted speculation he could in fact vote against that bill. If that happened, the vote would essentially be deadlocked and the government only has the current support of three crossbench MPs. It would give the government just 11 days before the last sitting week of the year to negotiate with the crossbench to try and find one extra vote to pass this bill. No doubt this has sent the government scrambling tonight, and it would be an extraordinary move by the disgraced former Labor minister, but all will be revealed tomorrow. And just to cap it all off, Pete, there has been a COVID scare here at State Parliament. Yesterday, a visitor tested positive to a rapid antigen test. All MPs and media who have been deemed close contacts have now been notified. Pete?
OK, thank you, Dougal Beattie.